we're introducing threshold AI oracles.
AI oracles, the natural evolution of AI as well as blockchain oracles coming together.
The most important thing is that now we bring intelligence to on-chain applications.
The idea is now that users can have any query.
We connect the two with one single process. Now we can do things in the completely unattended way.
We can expand the information that we bring on-chain way beyond just price sheet data. So yeah, well, Supra, we're bringing something very interesting to the market. Of course, we're known for developing protocols and designing algorithms, and including, of course, consensus algorithms, but also Oracle protocols, right? We were known originally for Oracle, although, of course, we've always worked on to be a layer one. What's really exciting, though, is that in this new era of AI, there's new things that can be done. This is something that we could not have predicted years ago either. However, of course, by having great researchers like Dr. Aniket Kate and Dr. Yang, we have brainstormed some very novel innovations. And this includes what we call it, we're introducing this new framework called Threshold AI Oracles. The evolution of blockchain oracles is going to incorporate AI agents. And this is really compelling because we can start to bring in all kinds of new information on chain. Now, the first question I have, and we'll try to keep this relatively simple, why is this an interesting evolution of oracle technology in the first place?
Sure. So if you consider the Oracle problems in blockchain in general, the idea is to bring the Web2 data into the Web3 space. And as AIs are getting evolved more and more, and they're having such a rapid growth in the Web2 space, it's very interesting and pertinent problem to bring this data from the Web2 space into the Web3 space or in blockchain. The first idea could be we can just simply take the whole AI engine and try to put that on the blockchain itself. But that's for a decentralized environment, for a really, truly decentralized environment. This can be very challenging, certainly not impossible, but can be challenging, and performance can be a significant issue in this particular space. So that's the reason the better idea could be we have some mechanism available so that we can indeed bring this Web2 data that is generated by AI agents or AI systems in general of any kind, from LLM to all sort of other anomaly detection systems or you name it. We bring that data to the Web3 space. The challenge there is that the information that is generated by the AI agent cannot be directly added in a secure and integrity protection manner on blockchains. And that's where the AI oracles comes in picture, where we use a mechanism in a very similar way, at least at the conceptual level, as our standard blockchain oracles, where we take this data, where the agents talk to the AI oracle agents, and from there, they collect the data and work on them, perform agreement on what could be the correct answer, and their agreed upon answer is put onto blockchains. So that's how I look at the AI oracles, the natural evolution of AI as well as blockchain oracles coming together at a nice juncture.
That's right. So a lot of the things we've already been deeply involved in designing, like DORA, Decentralized Oracle Agreement, this is a great foundation in which we can evolve it beyond that to other types of data beyond price feeds. But Dr. Yang, in your point of view as well, what is interesting to you in terms of this threshold AI oracle approach?
Well, to me, the most important thing is that now we bring intelligence to on-chain applications. So before, what you do is that you run your AI and you make a decision, and based on the decision, you make a move on-chain. So the two parts are entirely separate. The intelligent parts, the reasoning, the online search, validation of news, inference, and so on. And the parts that you make a move on-chain, for example, you may do a transfer, you may do a DeFi transaction, and so on. So because they are separate, it's hard to make automated tool such that you can execute certain actions unattended. So now if we manage to bring this AI on-chain as an oracle, then what happens is that we connect the two. So now with one single process, we can make AI inference, and we have calculations, online browsing, agent tools, and final decisions. And those decisions are directly reflected in your on-chain transactions, and you interact with dApps. So now we can do things in the completely unattended way, and that's a very good fit for our automation service.
So traditional oracles, we are primarily focused on pricey data, cryptocurrency, equities, commodities, FX, in real time. So we're processing a lot of information constantly, and verifying and putting it on chain and delivering it to over 60 other blockchains, by the way. Now, what's interesting about AI oracles is this idea of just-in-time service. Dr. Kate, you actually brought that up, and that was like a major impetus for me to say, hey, wait a second, this is a big deal. Can you explain what that means, just-in-time, and can you describe the opportunity here?
Indeed. So I will just put in a more interesting slash funny way here, the just-in-time, the way we look at it is kind of it's a feature, but it's also in a way a limitation, because if you look at all the price feed that typically Oracle is currently collecting, they're growing really fast. And if we can so easily see that the amount of data that's available just in the Web2 space is just enormous and gigantic. We just can't expect to bring all that data to blockchain and always have that ready at the fingertips of the users, okay? And this is certainly even better explained in AI Oracle space, where the idea is now that users can have any query. And the whole idea why this new AI revolution picked up is that users now know that they can have any question in their mind, and there is a friend available to them who will try to give an answer to their best ability. And we all know that these friends, these AI LLM engines and others are just improving and becoming better and better as we speak. So it's given the situation that we won't be able to bring these AI engines directly onto the blockchain, and the answer has to come outside. How can AI Oracle nodes know what data to collect in a predefined fashion? There is no limit to what can get asked, because there is no limit to, we can certainly say there is not much study limit to what available in the Web2 space. So that's the reason it's inherent in this space, when we look at AI Oracle or blockchain oracles grow, that we won't be able to predetermine all the things that users of the system may need or may want. And in such a scenario, it's just inherent that rather than try to predetermine what my users may want, AI Oracle system may prefer doing it otherwise, where a user have their own special queries and they put those queries onto the chain. And after looking those queries, the AI Oracle nodes come in picture and try to determine the answer for those queries and perform agreements on their answers and submit an aggregated response, which is endorsed by the entire Oracle system onto chain. So that's what we mean by just in time, that rather than try to predetermine that, which is just impossible in most scenarios, we try to work that out as the queries come. And this is very interestingly definable in AI space, because if you look at these inter prompts that are offered by all these new AI systems, they are of that kind only, that you ask us anything. And here also, once the user query comes, the Oracle nodes, the AI Oracle nodes interact with the AI system that they're connected to find out the answer and try to agree on that answer. That's where the summarization concept that David come in picture. And it's a very interesting AI problem in general. And they summarize their solution, they approve their solution, they sign on it and send that back to it. But it's very important to understand here that the speed is still essential here. And we rely that, assuming that the underlying AI systems are fast enough, the summarization, which is much easier function, and if we can do that efficiently and fast, then correspondingly that will result into users getting answer very efficiently. And just to consider that, although it looks like there are a lot of components from the real blockchain interaction perspective, there are only two transactions, a user submitting a request saying that I want answer for this, and the AI Oracle system just submitting a final answer that this is our answer and here's our threshold signature or multi-signature on that to prove that the system approves that answer.
That's great. Yeah. So, I mean, you touched upon the core issue of interacting with AI, which is couple of things. The benefits are that they can answer and reason about many different things. We cannot possibly have every single information put onto a blockchain. And at the same time, we have to make sure that the AI response is accurate. There's no hallucinations. There's a secure protocol to handle this. So this is a very exciting field, because what excites me personally is we can now expand the aperture of information that we bring on chain upon user requests way beyond just price feed data. It could be sentiment analysis. It could be world events, macro view of the economics, et cetera, economies of the world. And this can help inform your decisions in real time. And Supra also has automation built in. So this may trigger some sort of automated action, right? So we're really excited about this. I do want to emphasize that to get the details of what we're talking about with Threshold AI Oracle and our various approaches, do read the paper. And we're going to be making this available. By the time you see this video, you should be able to see the paper. The next question is for Dr. Yang. Dr. Yang, so we talked about like various phases as you roll out the service, right? I want us to just take a second because we're trying to condense the vision into a short clip here for our audience. At the extreme, at the end game, what can the AI Oracle service do beyond just answer response? Maybe they can do more than that.
Right. So we have three phases. I mean, current plan is to have three phases. So the first phase, the AI Oracle will supply some numbers, just like in price feeds, we give a number, which is the exchange rate between two different tokens. So now we can also give a number, which is output by the AI. For example, what's your prediction of Bitcoin price tomorrow? And that could also be a 1 to 10. What do you think about the current sentiment for Supra or another token? So because the output is a single number, so the dApp developer need to take care of the rest. So basically, the dev need to take this number and then do a transaction that uses this number, and that will be turned into an action, which can be buy some coins on the DeFi application, for example. So our part is just to give this number, and the rest of the work will be done by the dApp developer. So this is the first phase. As you see, the functionality is still rather limited, but we do bring intelligence on chain. So the second phase is that we provide not just a number, but the complete transaction. Okay, so the dApp developer just need to develop the smart contract, and then we will send this transaction calling a function, this entry function in the smart contract with appropriate parameters. So the dApp developer doesn't need to initiate this transaction from their ends and parse our number. Instead, we do this from the Oracle side, and that transaction is directly executed. So this reduces the workload of the dApp developers. It also enables more exciting applications. So as long as your smart contract supports certain functionalities, then maybe created transactions might be triggered on-chain using AI. So the third phase is that the dApp doesn't need to provide the smart contract beforehand. So our AI can write smart contract code and then release a new smart contract if that's needed. And then we can then issue a smart contract transaction. So this can create even more space for innovative apps and strategies. So that's what we have in mind for those three phases. And along the way, we'll also talk to dApp developers and see what are the concrete use cases and what exciting applications can be made with each phase of our design.
That's great. Yeah, so this is very exciting work we're doing here. And I want to emphasize that Supra's vertical integration, layer one smart contract platform, high throughput consensus algorithm, built-in Oracle, Dora, as well as soon to be coming Threshold AI Oracles, automation, cross-chain communication, on-chain randomness, single stack, shared security, our particular approach to, in our view, on what the future of this technology is that these things need to be in a shared security environment. And our Oracle data and our Threshold AI approach, et cetera, require security. And this is where I want you all to dive into the paper, use AI itself to ask questions around how does this work? How do we take information that is non-deterministic and safely cryptographically bring it on chain that can be actionable? And imagine a future where smart contract logic can be altered in real time by a Threshold Oracle system that are reasoning and bringing intelligence into their output and can craft new smart contract code. That's only going to be possible on Supra. And yes, that is a little bit in the future, but it's not as far as we think. The exponential growth of these technologies are incredible. So the call to action for everyone is take a look at the paper, take a look at our technology, take a look at the Threshold AI Oracle paper, take a look at the Supra 2.0 AutoFi paper, reason on your own, or actually with AI, as to what are the implications? What can be done with this technology in the future? We will also provide you some prompts and take a look at it. Thanks everyone for your time. Enjoy this.